Hi everyone! Welcome to another session of PWF Small Talk. And today, I was truly blessed by the topic in the Bible study earlier. And honestly, I couldn't hold back my tears. Naiiyak talaga ako when I was doing the advanced reading on this parable. And grabe, sobrang heart-piercing yung message ng parable na to. Today, I'm going to be joined by a sister of mine in Praying Wife Forum. She works side by side with me sa PWF Live Production. And without further ado, I want to introduce to you my fellow sister of mine, Sis Edel.
Hi, good afternoon, Sis Diana.
Hello, welcome. Oh, Sis Edel, your devotion kanina, ang daming realization and overpowering yung wisdom. So, Sis Edel, in this parable, Jesus really illustrate to us kung paano niya ni-relate ang banquet sa kingdom of God. So, can you further enlighten us with this?
So, Sis Diana, our study this afternoon is entitled The Parable of the Wedding Banquet. When I first studied about this as well, parang sabi ko, Lord, bakit parang ang ganda ng title? When we learned about it, when I tried to learn about more of this, I had the fear, a good kind of fear, the fear of the Lord. At the same time, I am excited. You know that? And yes, I also teared up. Kasi parang sabi ko, Lord, in my state right now, am I worthy? We did an interactive approach, diba? So, hinati-hati natin. This is a very short parable. Pero, maraming laman, maraming words na kailangang pagtuunan at bigyan ng kahulugan. Ano ba to ngayon? Because we know a parable is, we don't have to take a parable exactly by its words. So there's a deeper meaning on it. Well, let's begin. So Sis Diana, this parable is actually third of the parables that was spoken by Jesus to the high priests in the temple. The background of this one is that the high priests were actually intimidated of who Jesus is during that time. Why is he speaking or teaching the people? So that's when Jesus uttered this third parable. So in verse 2, it says, he said, the kingdom of heaven is like a king who prepared a wedding banquet for his son. So the kingdom of heaven is compared to a king, isang hari, no, who prepared a wedding banquet for his son. Why wedding banquet? Wedding banquet during those times are very prized. You will feel special if you are invited in a wedding banquet. So prized that it is a spectacular event. To be invited is a very big opportunity, lalo kung wala ka naman sa mataas na estado. Today, a wedding is a very significant social event also to a person's life. So when we get invited, hindi ba parang feeling natin, special ako sa mag-asawang to. So that's how we feel, di ba, when we get invited. And here, sa panahon na yun kasi, it is always the father who prepares a wedding banquet for a son, for a prince, hindi ba? I remember Sister Hannah's study on proposal. She also explained this one, that it is very important for a father to prepare his son's wedding. So we learned today that since this is a parable, the king who is God has prepared a wedding banquet. What is a wedding banquet? It is actually the word of God. Isang mahabang mesa na puno ng pagkain. And we know that as believers or followers of Christ, we don't have to eat with bread alone. Hindi ba? Sinabi rin yon sa Bible. We have to also eat, as Christians, sabi nga, our solid food is the word of God. So here, the wedding banquet that we are being invited at is the word of God. So Would you like to react on that muna, Sis Diana?
Yes, actually, when you were saying about wedding banquet, yung punong-puno ng pagkain, we can see how God really loves His Son para ipaghanda niya ng ganong kag-ingrande, di ba? I can imagine talaga the kingdom of heaven na as a wedding banquet for His Son talaga na ano, ingrande.
Yes, so we can move on, Sis D. Here at Matthew 22 verse 3, sabi, He sent His servants to those who had been invited to the banquet to tell them to come, but they refused to come. What I did not like here is the word, they refused to come. I think more of a lot of the sisters was able to reflect that today. When the verse says, He sent His servants, ipinadala ng Panginoon yung mga nag-work para sa kanya, di ba? So, His servants mean people who are close to Him. As a king, people who works for Him. People who knows Him. Because you cannot serve the Lord if you don't know Him, di ba? And during that time, kings, the servants of the king, lives in the palace, di ba? So, he sent his servants, and sabi, to tell them to come. Those who had been invited. So prior that, alam na actually ng mga iniimbitahan that they are or they were invited before. Diba? So there is already an expectation that they will get the word from the king that, come na, punta na. Diba? But what's so sad about this is they have refused. And in this parable, this is just the first invitation. And this is the first refusal. So sad. Actually, it seems so strange that those who were invited refused an invitation to a royal wedding. If it's the king who invites, therefore, it is a royal wedding. In grande, hindi siya basta kasalan lang sa tabi-tabi, di ba? This actually illustrates the principle that there is no logical reason. God's good gifts are refused. Tayo kasing mga tao, sometimes because hindi natin nakikita, yung hindi natin nahahawakan. There are times that we refuse to understand what it is. Yun, Sis Diana, would you like to react on that?
Yes. Actually, ito yung ano ko eh, reflect kanina doon sa ating Bible study. Kasi I was wondering then, what caused them to refuse such invite? Which sinabi mo nga is, it's a royal wedding from the king. Pero bakit? Are they busy? Do they have something more important to address? This invite in the modern day, parang Oscars. And ang haba ng buhok mo to refuse, di ba? Yung underlined word na they refuse to come, which talaga napapakunot ako nung nabasa ko siya. Pero let's see on the next few verses, ano yung cause nito or ano? Let's see, let's find out.
Okay, so in verse 4, Jesus said, "Then He sent some more servants and said, 'Tell those who have been invited that I have prepared my dinner. My oxen and fattened calf have been butchered, and everything is ready. Come to the wedding banquet.'" I love this verse because it says here, He sent some more servants, hindi ba? And pinabalikan niya pa yung mga taong nag-refuse sa first invitation. Sinabi pa ulit na, those who have been invited, the same as the first one, those who have been invited, yung mga nasa listahan ni Lord. Nasa listahan ka ni, hindi ba? Sabi, that I have prepared my dinner. Prepared, past tense, tapos na, nakahanda na, people. Parang gano'n, ano na, ready to eat na. Hindi na kayo magluluto. Pipila na lang kayo, kunin nyo yung plato nyo and fill up your plate as much as you want. This is the king showing how persistent he is in making that invitation. And he tried to make it as attractive as possible. Diba? For him to say, it's prepared. So, ipinapakita niya na, ito na, handa na. Sino bang hindi na-attract sa isang buffet table na punong-puno ng pagkain? Any kind of dishes, you know, di ba? Dito sa Philippines, it's very popular to have that eat-all-you-can type of buffets. And it's really inviting to go and try to taste each and every dish, di ba? So, ganun ka-attractive na sinasabi pa ni Lord dito na, I need Jesus na, my oxen and fattened cattle have been butchered. ibig sabihin yung pinakamataba, pinakamasarap yun, di ba? Pinaka-inalagaan na klase ng hayop. Di ba sa atin, here in the Philippines, it's very popular to have lechon. And the bigger the lechon, the buffet table looked better. He really wanted those who had been invited to come. Past tense, those who have been invited. When a great social event happened in Jewish culture during that day, people are invited without setting a time. So here on the appropriate day, when the host is ready to receive the guests, they sent out messengers kasi to say that all the things were ready and it was time to come for the feast. So then, the king in this parable had long ago sent out his invitations, hindi ba? But it was not until everything was prepared that the final summon was issued. But then, sadly, it was insultingly refused. You don't come to God's feast and prepare your own meal. Yun yung pinapakita dito. He has had it, made it ready for us. We just have to come and receive it. Ganun ka mahal tayo ni God that He would prepare all things and make it all ready for us, all the food ready for us. Sis Diana, would you like to react on that?
May question ako ito, sis. For the benefit of those who are watching right now na somehow starting to know Christ or not familiar with this parable, can you relate this verse, yung mga underlined words, yung servants dyan, ano ba yung parang portrayal ng servant in this modern day time?
Well, I believe yung mga servants na sinasabi dito are those people who serve Jesus, who serves the church. The church is, as we know, are the people who believes in Jesus. These are the servants who are giving their time to share the word to the unbelievers. During those times kasi, God's people, na sinasabi in the Bible dati, ang alam lang natin, those Israelites, right? Sila yung inuuna na tawagin in the kingdom. It says here, God prepared the dinner. And what is the dinner? The oxen and the fattened cattle. And in other versions, it says fattened calf. And He butchered that calf. During those times, ang sacrifice na ibinibigay is always the best animal they have. The best cattle, the best sheep, the fattened calf, pinataba talaga for an occasion. As we have studied it deeper, the oxen here and the fattened cattle here that has been butchered is Jesus Himself. God is the one who orchestrated that His Son, His beloved Son, will be crucified on the cross for us believers to follow Him, to be saved from our sins. When He said, everything is ready because it is already finished. Jesus, more than 2,000 years ago, already paid for our sins. And in the present time, the only thing that we have to do is to come to Him, accept Him, receive the sacrifice, and acknowledge Him as our Lord and Savior.
Itong verse na to, ang daming laman. We can see that what we were talking about here, actually, the people who said by God to send the invite to other people, di ba? We can see here how God really prepared. He Himself prepared it for us. Nakaka-amaze and nakakahabag. Parang tayong may personal chef doon sa banquet na yun at si God yun, di ba? Sabi mo kanina. That's really amazing to think that way. Let's see on the next few slides.
Yes, I have been reminded you said that He prepared. Yes, because He said, I prepared, di ba, in verse 4. So let's go to verses 5 and 6. Sabi ni Jesus, but they paid no attention and went off. One to his field, another to his business. The rest seized his servants, mistreated them, and killed them. When we asked our sisters earlier about their reflection on this, maraming nagsabi that there's nothing to like on these verses. But it is true na kung ikaw yung king, hindi ba? Nakakalungkot isipin that we as humans are capable of doing this. Sabi, they paid no attention and went off. paano natin siya i-apply sa ngayon? There are a lot of people who have been shared with the word. There were a lot of people who listened. But then after that, what did they do? Some stayed and listened. But then finally, they just went off. Some, nagsisimula pa lang, maalis na sila because they don't want to pay attention to it. Kasi for them, there are more other things more important. Sabi dito sa verse, one to his field, another to his business. So they have more priorities in life that they think more important than what is being shared to them. So also sabi dito, some servants were seized. In the New Testament, we know that the apostles, the disciples of Jesus, some of them were hanged, some of them were in jail. So they were mistreated and some of them were killed. The underlined words here, literal. And in the modern times, a lot of Bible-believing Christians are being persecuted because of their faith. I think this is not hard to understand. And what's sad in these verses is that it really shows here that the invitation has been refused, and hindi lang basta refused, with a negative response. Nakakalungkot that the reaction of those who were invited are actually not making sense at all, di ba?
Isa ako doon sa mga participant kanina who see nothing good on these verses. It's all full of negativity, and I can imagine also yung Acts of Apostles, how they really died in their faith. They can see here that the servants, they were captured, they were mistreated, and some were killed then, di ba? Same as the apostles, the disciples, di ba? They really died in their faith. It's very consistent on how this parable really talks about the people who are putting one thing more important than Christ. It's also visible in this modern day time din, di ba? Kasi like, we can see a lot of people who thinks that their business is more than attending to the invite of the Lord. May kanya-kanyang agenda ba? We don't realize that there is a better agenda for us. And naka-plan na yun. Actually, tayo na lang yung hinihintay, di ba?
That's right. It reminded me of what Pastor Peter told before about time. There are people who would say, wala kasi akong oras. I don't have the time, di ba? But in reality is, just because it is not our priority. Diba? And this verse, they show that one went to his field, the other to his business. So it really shows that a lot of people are not prioritizing Jesus or a good news or the invitation, which is yun nga ngayon, the sharing of the word.
May isa din akong insight dyan. Sinabi mo yung about time. Usually when we receive invites, katulad ng halimbawa, simpleng birthday invite lang. Let's say in-invite yon on a weekend. Diba, weekend usually is our rest day time. It's our time for ourselves. It's a time for unwinding. Medyo napapaisip ka when an invite comes, should you go? This event is really special. Or pupunta ako kasi parang iniisip mo na you just have to attend. Parang napipilitan ka lang to attend. So makikita mo doon, there are two responses in attending to an invite. One is, when you're invited, are you excited to go to that invite? Or second, when you receive that invite, parang you're dragging yourself na tama na tamad ka, but you have to do it. You can see the priorities. Nandun yung yung eagerness mo to obey or to go to that invite. Pero yung heart mo is, nahiwalay siya. Hindi siya as one. Para siyang gawaing bahay na kailangan mong gawin. Ganun lang. Pagkatapos mo, okay, tapos na, okay, naka-attend na ako, uwi na ako, ganun. Parang eat and run, ganun. Ganun yung nakikita ko na sa pag-refuse ng mga tao in a certain special occasion or even on this kind of banquet, on this kind of feast wherein you can really soak yourself in God's word. Na this is not an ordinary feast. This is not an ordinary banquet or an ordinary party. This is a party of wherein it will change your life. Let's come to this party kasi when you got out of this party, you will be totally a new person. It's not a normal handaan. It's not a normal salo-salo. It is a salo-salo of a lifetime.
There's something I remember pa pala sa na-share natin kanina. There are three kinds of people. In Proverbs, sinabi rin yun that there are the wise, the simple, and the fools. And here it shows, no, that the wise people would just obey God, no questions. But here it shows there the two other kinds, the simple, the ones who doesn't really know who God is. So they don't know how important he is. That's why they would just went off their own ways. And the other ones, the fools. What's so sad about the fools? Because they have knowledge of who God is. And they try to challenge the idea of him, the idea of his lordship, the idea of who he is in our life. And it's so sad because they have that knowledge, they would ridicule or they would persecute yung mga nagsiserve. Ang hindi nila alam is when they persecute those people who serve the Lord, they're not persecuting these people. They're persecuting the Lord, the King whom they serve. Di ba? It's just like what Jesus said to Saul when he was still Saul, Paul, Apostle Paul, that why are you persecuting me? That's what he said. But Saul, sino ba yung mga hinahabol niya? Di ba, the apostles, sino ba yung namatay? Si Stephen. Sino ba yung mga gusto niyang ipakulong? Di ba? The Christians. It's not Jesus. But Jesus would take it personally. Why are you persecuting me? So it's the same with this. These people are mostly knowledgeable, the fools. They have a big knowledge of who God is. But they refuse. They still refuse and they would maltreat them. I think that's how I can relate it to the now.
I can totally relate. And I hope our viewers here as well can somehow give them an idea on what we're trying to explain here regarding those people talaga who are putting other things more than going to God's invite. So let's move on.
So in verse 7, Jesus said the king was enraged. He sent his army and destroyed those murderers and burned their cities. I remember sabi ng mga sisters, there's nothing to like here, no? In my own point of view, that the king was enraged. I like this. Because it shows here na we really have to leave room for God's wrath. Siya ang lalaban para sa atin. And here, because he was enraged, how his servants were maltreated, he sent his army. And we know that, di ba meron pa tayong ibang term na angel armies, if it's from heaven. So here, the king sent his army and destroyed those murderers. And they were not even allowed na dumami pa because he burned their cities. So that includes who? Their family, their neighbors, those people who are around them. So this is something to dislike about. But what I liked about this is the Lord will not allow na ganun lang ang gagawin sa mga servants niya. So I think my encouragement for servants is to never get discouraged kasi the Lord fights our battle. The Lord can also react. Because here, the king reacted enraged. And he had a rightful judgment upon those offenders. Not only that they rejected his invitation, but he also murdered the messengers. Would you like to react on that, Sis Diana?
When you explain this verse, it came to my thought na this verse is pertaining to God's wrath. Let God avenge us. Ang ating photo to describe it is fire, talagang enraged. And ramdam mo yung galit niya, how his servant was persecuted. Let's move on to our next slide and let's see what happens next.
We can see here at verses 8 and 9. So Jesus said, then he said to his servants, the wedding banquet is ready. Inulit niya ulit, diba? But those I invited did not deserve to come. So go to the street corners and invite to the banquet anyone you find. So again, inulit dito yung word na ready. Ready na. No, nakahain na. Kumbaga sa Tagalog, nakahain na mga kapatid, mga kababayan. So, nakahain na. And this is actually the third invitation that the wedding is ready. That the wedding banquet is ready. Meaning, it doesn't mean that the marriage contract is ready. Because during those times, nauuna ang banquet, they celebrate. They feast first before the actual marriage, and then they feast more for days. Ganun ang ginagawa before. Here, sabi, but those I invited did not deserve to come. Those who were invited in those two first invitations, because they refused him. Sinabi na ni Lord, okay, hayaan nyo na sila. Leave them. Hindi sila deserving. So sabi, go to the street corners and invite the banquet, anyone you find. So before, during those times, Israelites are the ones called God's people. And when Jesus said here, anyone you find, that includes na the Gentiles, the foreign ones. That, and in the present times, that includes us. So hindi lang yung nasa bloodline, I think, of Israelites ang iniimbitahan na. And this parable shows that God is already inviting, or Jesus is inviting everyone, all creation, to come and be in banquet with him and his son, to come and eat the food that he prepared for us, that come and learn the word, hear the word, put into their hearts the word that is written on the Bible. Napakahirap aruhin yung knowledge na Bible kasi is one of the widest distributed book globally. And the Bible is the most translated Bible. Why? Because all creation, all humans are to read, are to be fed by the word of God. So that's how we dissected this verses. Sis Diana, you wanna react on that?
You mentioned earlier, di ba? Invite sila, pero hindi sila pumunta. It only shows na it makes you not deserving to come in this banquet. Pero it doesn't mean na masama ka or immoral ka. You're not worthy to come here. Kasi it says here in verse 9 na anyone you find. So whether good or bad, you're invited. Pero those who are only not deserving are the ones who refuse the invitation. And nung in-invite yung maraming tao, yung parang naging open party na yung celebration, yung banquet, di ba? Parang nanghihinayang ako dun sa mga nag-refuse. Sayang, hindi siya makasama dun sa party. Hindi siya makasama doon sa celebration. Hindi siya makasama sa banquet. Hindi nila ma-witness kung ano yung meron doon sa pinaghandaan ng king for them.
All of us naman kasi is unworthy because of the grace of God. We became worthy to receive him. I think that's the only one that I can add on these two verses.
Let's move on to our next slide.
So in verse 10, Jesus said, so the servants went out into the streets and gathered all the people they could find, the bad as well as the good, and the wedding hall was filled with guests. So ito na yung sinasabi natin kanina, that not only those people who are living within the kingdom was invited na. They have gathered all the people na. Anybody they could find. Kahit siguro yung mga street people, no? Yung mga nakatira sa kalye, yung mga namamalimos. The good, the bad, as well as the good. Siguro, ultimo na yung mga unlawful person, no? During the time, there are people who gambles, you know? People who are deep in sin. Pero, sabi ni God, imbitahan nyo na rin sila. Share the word to them. Kumbaga, in the present time, it doesn't matter what kind of person that is. You don't have to look at who that person is before you share the word of God to him. You have to look at how God looks at him. Diba? If God here, or the king here, says, gather all the people you could find, bad as well as the good, walang exempted. Whether you feel that this person is deep in sin or this person is living a very righteous life or this person is either committing illegal activities on their business or on their job or this person is a very honest employee, doesn't matter kay God. Kasi sabi dito, bad as well as the good. And the wedding hall was filled with guests. So the wedding hall where the banquet is ready. was filled with people. So let's see who are the guests are. Sis Diana, would you like to comment on that first?
Yes, ano, actually kanina, parang sunod-sunod yung ating negative versus, pero ngayon, we can see how they are having a feast talaga because the wedding hall is filled ng tao. I can imagine talaga na parang isang banquet hall na punong-puno ng tao. And those people are iba-ibang klaseng tao, like what you said. Talagang walang exemption. Walang category na sinusunod. Anyone na they can find is invited. This one is a very nice verse to reflect on. In this verse, we can also see na walang distinction yung pag-invite ng tao. This invitation was sent to all. This invitation is just pure, loving, generous invitation to everyone na walang pinipili. Kung kanina yung invitation was sent to those listed people, VIPs, kumbaga, mga nakalista, this one, walang VIP. Everyone is invited. I really like this verse. So let's move on to the next slide.
Here at verses 11 and 12, sabi ni Jesus, but when the king came in to see the guests, he noticed a man. He noticed a man there who was not wearing wedding clothes. He asked, how did you get in here without wedding clothes? Friend, the man was speechless. So ang ganda ng pagkakahimay natin kanina dito, di ba? Let's first talk about the first few underlined words. Sabi, the king came in to see. Who's the king here? Sabi natin kanina, di ba? It is God. The wedding hall was filled with people. Saka siya pumasok. And he came to see. He came to see everyone. Each and every one of them. And then he noticed a man. What does it say? That God looks at each and every one of us. Bawat isa sa atin pala, mai-inspect, sis. May inspection. Kumbaga sa isang sundalo, you know, you go in ranks. And each and every one of you, in a weekly basis, sa amin nun sa academy, in a weekly basis, we get to have a Saturday inspection from head to toe, up to yung ilalim ng mga nails mo, kailangan malinis, pati yung pagkakatupi ng panyo mo, malinis. Everything in perfection. Dapat walang dumi at all. Alam mo ba yung mga lalaki, yung shave nilang ganito, hinahawakan yan kapag may gaspang? May demerits ka. So this is what I have really liked about this verse, that the King, God Himself, will look at us from head to toe. That's how important we are for Him. For us to be pure. For us to be without defect in His standard. And then he said, he noticed a man there who was not wearing a wedding clothes. So I remember one of our sisters, she was able to tell us, paano ba ginagawa kasi ang wedding banquet before? So when you get invited to a wedding banquet, the servants or the messengers of the word of invitation would also give out a wedding robe or wedding clothes, how they call it. I think it's a wedding robe. Tapos, if pupunta ka na, you have to wear it. You have to don it. So if you're not wearing that, it means hindi ka naka-receive firsthand nung invitation. Hindi ba? So, dati lahat ng iniimbitahan, one-on-one pala ng mga messenger. Kasi how could you get that wedding dress kung hindi ka hinarap in person ng messenger ng king or ng servant ng king. So that's how important we are. VIP, no? Hindi lang tinanggap sa mail or narinig mo sa kapitbahay. Pinuntahan ka. Hinarap ka. Kinausap ka. Ipinaliwanag sa'yo. Kailan? Saan? Anong oras? At anong isusuot mo provided pa? That's how important we are in the eyes of God. Diba? Ganun mo mararamdaman na napaka-importante kong tao. Diba? Kahit ang dami-dami mong imbitado, bawat isa sa inyo, bawat isa sa atin ay napaka-importante sa mata ng Panginoon. Let's talk about the man that was not wearing a wedding clothes. So, pwede palang makapasok, no, sa wedding hall nang hindi mo suot yung wedding dress, yung wedding clothes. So, it means that there are people, this is how I understand it, there are people who accepted Jesus. They just heard it, accepted it, but really never put it into their hearts. That's how I understand this. Because when he went inside the wedding hall, may na-miss siyang instruction. Hindi niya isinuot yung wedding clothes. Baka tinanggap lang niya, inilapag niya, and then he forgot about it on the wedding day or in the wedding banquet, the day itself. Kaya, when he went there, hindi niya suot. Hindi ba? And I'm sure this person noticed that he is the only person that is not wearing the wedding dress because ma-out of place ka. Hindi ba? And in verse 12, Jesus said the word friend. So, God still considered that person as a friend. Why? Because he acknowledges who God is. He understood who he is. He understood who sent off the invitation. So in the present times, there are a lot of people who accepted Christ as their Lord and Savior, but doesn't really want to wear the righteousness of Christ. And guilty as I am right now in front of everyone, I am a backslider. I have accepted Christ as my Lord and Savior when I was younger, but I really did not know who he is. And then I forgot about him. I have not gone to church for years. I even started my family without him. I haven't really acknowledged him. I am so blessed because hindi siya nawalang ng pasensya sa akin. And I am praying that that time when the Lord will have to come na and see and notice me, that I am wearing that wedding clothes that he prepared and he gave me para hindi niya masabi sa akin na, why are you not wearing the wedding clothes, friend? And well, here, it says here pa, no, that this man was speechless. Hindi siya nakapagrason. Wala siyang nasabi. But for me, the moment that the Lord here asked a question, he's still giving you that chance. Meron pa rin slight chance. Yun nga yung explain ng isa rin nating sister na he considered as a friend and he still asked you a question. Hindi ka lang niya basta pinatapon eh. Diba? He still gave you that chance. May chance pa, kaibigan, but the man remained speechless. Diba? Kasi siguro ako nun, bigla na lang akong luluhod sa harap nung, ni God and would say na, Lord, I'm sorry, naiwan ko lang eh. Nakalimutan ko. Nakalimutan ko ngayon pala siya, hindi ko nadala. You know? Diba? Parang in the modern times siguro, I would say na, naiwan ko sa bahay eh, layo ng bahay. Hindi na ako bumalik, dumiretso na ako dito. Pwede bang? Baka may extra ka dyan. Baka pwedeng bayan niyo ako ng bago. Hindi ba, Sis Diana? Would you like to react on that?
Actually, this verse, when I read this verse, when I was doing my advanced study, the Lord knows I really burst into tears and hindi ko alam kung bakit ako umiyak sa verse na to. Knowing that when I found out na the clothes were also provided by the king. So, sabi mo kanina, everything is provided. Talagang, tayo lang talaga yung kulang. Yun naman talaga yung, ano natin dito, yung picture natin dito. Atenda lang tayo. Kasi everything is provided. Na i-imagine ko yung sarili ko, how servants of the Lord trying to reach me and send that kind of invite to reach me talaga. And offering me that robe. Nagburst talaga ako sa tears when I'm starting to imagine that. And the Lord knows also I am a backslider. Pareho tayo. Yes. And ano, the Lord is so gracious to us talaga, offering that kind of robe. And ano, sabi mo kanina, that robe is the robe of righteousness. God's righteousness, hindi self-righteousness ah. It's God's righteousness. That righteousness only comes from Him. Meron akong verse dito. It's Isaiah 61 verse 10. Sabi dito, I delight greatly in the Lord. My soul rejoices in my God. For He has clothed me with garments of salvation and arrayed me in a robe of His righteousness. So you can see talaga that attire, that provided clothing, it really symbolizes His righteousness talaga. This verse, ang daming kakapulutan ng aral, especially when you also emphasize how the king addresses that person as a friend still, and questioned, yung the moment that he questioned, gave him a chance to still speak for himself, explain himself, diba? So, binibigyan pa rin tayo ng chance. But Siguro, out of shame and guilt, the man remains speechless. And with that shame and guilt, dun talaga tayo babagsak.
Sis Diana, I want to show just this one. Actually, isa siya sa devotion ko the other day. So I have made this poster. Isaiah 61:10. So this is what Sis Diana is sharing to us, sisters. So thank you so much, Sis Diana.
Let's move on to our next verse.
Yes, Sis Diana. Here, Jesus said, then the king told the attendants, tie him hand and foot and throw him outside into the darkness where there will be weeping and gnashing of teeth. For many are invited, but few are chosen. This is something na ayaw natin mangyari sa atin, hindi ba? This is something that we have to really be fearful about. That in that moment that the Lord will give us that last chance, that moment that the Lord will ask us, how have we been as a follower of Him? Have we really followed or not following, or we were just pretending? So, sabi rito, tie him. Ang personal take ko dito is to tie him para wala na siyang mahilang iba. This is how I understand it. And sabi, throw him outside, no? Sakit. Hindi ka lang basta pinalabas. Tinapon ka pa. And where there will be weeping and gnashing of teeth. Ang sakit. Naparusahan ka pa. Ang take ko really dito is, it's not just you are taken out of the celebration or the event. You were punished, or we get punished if we don't wear that wedding robe or the righteousness of Christ. May kaparusahan. And it says here, many are invited. Yes, all of us are actually invited. Every human being is invited, as per sinabi nga kanina. But only few are chosen. Only those who are wearing the wedding garment. One of our reflection questions is, do we want our names to be taken out in the Book of Life? And what can we do about it? My personal take on this is to never remove that clothing if you were given one already. As somebody who backslided, I think I am enjoying more the presence of God and still continuing to make sure that hindi siya basta natatanggal. As wives, actually, we have the tendency to sometimes when we are filled with our emotions and we are being given some situation, nakakalimutan natin yung ating identity in Christ. And we tend to remove that clothing, that righteousness na idinon sa atin ng Panginoon. And many times talaga, aaminin ko na I have not perfected this. Sometimes, nakakalimutan kong isuot yon yung righteousness ni Jesus. And I tend to react. Sometimes, because of my emotions, and I am not asking to be filled with the Holy Spirit, nakakalimutan kong isuot. Asan yung wedding clothes? Asan yung righteousness? Hindi ba? Because righteousness, the righteousness of Christ is not something from us. It is from Christ. So we have to make sure that we always wear it. We have to cover ourselves with it because we cannot do it on our own. Diba sabi nga sa Bible, we can do nothing without Jesus on our side, without having that Holy Spirit to lead us. We always have to ask the Holy Spirit to lead us. So the righteousness of Christ will not be left behind. No, hindi na uuna yung self natin, hindi na uuna yung flesh. Sis Diana, would you like to react on that?
Those people who were invited, na good or bad, mixed kinds of people. You can be morally living your life or sabihin na nating napakabait mo when you live your life. Pero as long as you're not putting that robe of righteousness, you cannot enter that banquet. Kasi parang yun yung pinaka entry mo to join the others in that celebration, in that feast. And hindi mo naman nasabi na kahit ikaw ay murderer o ikaw pinaka immoral na tao, you can still stay as long as you have that robe, di ba? Na you can stay what you want. Yung robe ng righteousness na yun symbolizes, God's righteousness symbolizes as your key. Sabi mo kanina, the robe is like, ano, Jesus Christ. You put on Jesus Christ. And we all know that no one comes to the Father except through Jesus. He's the way, the truth, and the life for us to really reunite with our Father. And ang ganda lang kasi itong verse 14 na many are invited but few are chosen. Actually, ito lagi ko iniisip every time we have an event, every time we have a webcast, every time we have like this small talk, we can send invites as siguro i-boost pa natin sa Facebook kahit marami pang makakita niyan. But only those people chosen will come to watch whatever we have here, whatever we are doing here in Praying White Forum, whatever God is asking us to do for those people. For us, we always have a choice whether to accept that invitation, that invite. It's our will, it's our freedom of choice, whether we're going to attend to that or not. God is always sending us an invite in many ways. And siya din ang nag-choose kung sino yung gustong pumunta sa invite. And we also have a choice then. For many are invited, but few are chosen.
Amen. Thank you, Sis Diana.
So, Sis, we reached down to the end of this devotion. But I have a question for you regarding this. I have just one question. Why do you think God chose others and yung iba hindi niya pinipili?
In this parable, it's very important, yung wedding garment. I think that is one of the key. It also showed here that without the wedding garment, we can come inside the wedding hall. But then, time will come, that God will come. And He will look at each and everyone to see who's wearing the wedding clothing or not. And the only key is everybody who gets invited not really don the wedding clothing, which is accepting Jesus as their Lord and Savior. At paano malalaman ni Lord yun? We learn that robe, that clothing, is the righteousness of Christ. How can the righteousness of Christ be seen in you if hindi mo siya ipinamumuhay? I think that's one key. Na lahat tayo inimbitahan, lahat ng creation ni God inimbitahan. Whether ano pa ang estado mo sa buhay, whether nagkasala ka, malaki o maliit, ang titingnan ng Panginoon after mo siya tanggapin as your Lord and Savior is paano mo inapply sa buhay mo yung righteousness na ibinigay niya sa'yo. Kasi ibinigay yun, di ba? Inaabot lang yun during the invitation. Maraming ibang tumanggap ng invitation, hindi naman nila isinuot. Ang sarap isipin in that way kasi na you were handed. The moment you receive Christ as your Lord and Savior, ibinigay sa'yo, iniabot sa'yo yung isusuot mo. The question is susuot ko ba to? Gagawin ko ba siya? I remember I posted one time on my social media when I said, if the Lord would ask me, who am I? Ang sagot ko is, sayo, Lord. Sayo means submit, abide, yield, and obey. And that is my aim. For now, until now, I am a work in progress. Siguro yung blessing ni Lord of my obedience, hindi ko pa natatanggap ngayon. Because there's still more for me to improve on. There's still more of me to abide on His word, to obey. Kasi hindi ka naman makaka-abide at makaka-obey in words eh. Lahat yun makikita in our actions. It's more on donning that wedding cloth and not taking it off again, ever again. I think when the Lord God knows whom He is choosing, I think that applies to us wives. Marami sa atin siguro yung nakilala na kay Lord pero not really wearing that righteousness. May mga panahon na nakakalimutan siguro nating isuot paglabas natin ng bahay, nagpuntang palengke, nagmaneho, and yung mga simpleng uminit yung ulo mo. Nakapag-discussion ka sa isang establishment, is that righteous in the eyes of God? You can start questioning yourself, am I showing my kids that I am wearing the righteousness of Jesus? I think that is something that we could learn as wives and as mothers. We have to have that intentionality of wearing Jesus every day, wearing the righteousness of Jesus every day to be a good model, a good example to our spouses and our children. I am here discussing this, Sis Diana, but I am being convicted in every word that I am uttering. I know that it is Holy Spirit led and ang daming naituro sa akin ng study na to. Making me fear that the Lord come one day because He said He will come like a thief in the night. And nakalimutan kong isuot yung wedding robe. So I am praying always that the Holy Spirit will not leave me, so I can always be seen as wearing Jesus's righteousness in my life. So I think, Sis Diana, that's one thing I can tell our fellow wives and fellow mothers.
Thank you for that, Sis Edel. Actually, this talk, this devotion of yours also touched me in so many ways, convicted me as well, and make me realize so many things talaga. And one of which is those invites that I always refused before. Napapagnilayan ko how I refuse each and every invite, how the Lord always sent invites through me, through His servants. It took me 30 years to respond on that invite. Kaya, thank you, Lord, for sending me invites nonstop. And thank you, Sis Edel, for being God's mouthpiece for us. And do you have a few words before we part?
I would like to encourage sisters na nanonood na itong ating small talk. Maybe some of you came and watched na hindi nyo sinasadya. Basta na lang kayo nanood at tinapos nyo hanggang dulo. This is the time that the Lord is asking you to receive His invitation. Napakaganda ng banquet na ipinrepare sa atin ng Panginoon. And all we have to do is come. Wear His wedding robe. Wear the wedding clothing that He has prepared for us. Wala kang ibang gagawin but to step in, wear that wedding clothes and step in, come. And eat the banquet that He has prepared. So I think I would like to invite sisters who are watching right now for a short prayer. Lord God Almighty, You're so sovereign, Panginoon. You are the Lord that create all things in this world, Lord Jesus. You're so great. And we are not deserving of Your greatness, Lord Jesus. But here You come inviting us, inviting me, Panginoon, to a banquet that You have prepared, to a banquet that where You have butchered the best cattle and Your fattened calf for me, for us to taste, Lord Jesus. And we thank You for that, Lord God. And Lord, as You're inviting me today, I would like to respond on that, on yes, Lord Jesus, I would like to accept You as my Lord and my mighty Savior. I accept You, Lord Jesus, as the King of my life. Panginoon, pagharian Niyo po ang buhay ko. Lord God, I believe in Your power. I believe that You are the one who will bring me closer to the righteousness that You have prepared for me, Lord God. I believe, Lord Jesus, that You will be the one to cleanse me of all the sins that I have in the past. Make a new person out of me, a new person that radiates Your face, where Your face shines upon me. Lord, may the robe of righteousness that You have been offering us to accept be seen on me, worn, Lord, dawn on my shoulder. Be the first one to be noticed kahit po nasa malayong distansya, Panginoon. Inyong katarungan lamang. Lord Jesus, I confess You as my Lord and Savior. I am so grateful that I have known You today, Lord Jesus. I would like to confess the sins that I have done in the past, Lord. Patawarin Niyo po ako, Lord Jesus. Baguhin Niyo po ako. Isuot Niyo po sa akin tamang kasuotan kung saan makikita ng mga tao na ako po ay bagong nilalang, Lord Jesus. Lord, we thank You, we bless You, and be the King of our life. Reign in us, reign in me. I surrender You everything that I have, Lord Jesus, and I would follow You, and I will submit to Your commands, and I want to be an obedient follower of Christ, Lord God. Lord, write my name in the book of life, Panginoon, and help me to be still. Holy Spirit, fill me in every single day of my life. I will never forget the dawn, that wedding garment that the Lord has given me. All this we ask in the mighty name of our Lord Jesus, our bridegroom. Amen. Thank you, Sis Diana.
Grabe. Sobrang emotional ng ating talk today. Ganon tayo talaga kausapin ni Lord. Thank you, Sis Edda. Thank you for your heart talk on this devotion. Your heart to serve the Lord. Do this devotion with us. Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you for using Your servants, Lord. And we pray that all of you who are watching right now, all of you who are chosen, we'll be seeing you again to our next small talk, to our next events of Praying Wife Forum. Thank you for spending time with us. And be beautiful. Inside and
out.
Out. Bye. Thank you, everyone.